Hi, this is Eric with mobilemusthave.com and liveinlight.net. And today we're going to talk through how to optimally configure the wireless networks on a Pepwave router. Now, before we get into hopping over to the computer and showing you the screenshots and all the settings, I want to talk to you a little bit about Wi-Fi. Specifically kind of what the flavors are and what specific frequencies are good for what use cases. So most Pepwave devices, whether you're looking at our full timer bundle all the way up to our Ultimate Road Warrior bundle, will have a wireless chipset that can communicate in multiple frequencies, specifically 2.4 gigahertz Wi-Fi or 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi. It's really 5.8 gigahertz Wi-Fi, but everyone calls it 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi or 5G. Don't confuse that with cellular 5G. That's a completely different thing. That means fifth generation. The terminology can get confusing. For today's video, we're talking only about Wi-Fi. And when we use the term Wi-Fi, we're talking about the network local to your RV or boat or whatever your mobile setup is. So that's usually like a 1 to 200 or so foot range around your RV with optimal kind of service around 50 feet or less of wireless connectivity going from the Pepwave device to your other devices like your phone or your laptops, etc. Smart TVs, all of that stuff. So by default out of the box, the wireless in the Pepwave is configured to basically run on what's called auto, which means that the Pepwave will decide based on the devices and how many devices you have on the network, which devices to put on the 2.4 gigahertz network and which to put on the 5 gigahertz network. And when they switch between the networks, you may experience issues. It's not the worst way to set things up, but we tend to recommend that you split out the networks into two separate networks for optimal performance while on the road. The reason why we recommend you split the 2.4 gigahertz and 5 gigahertz wireless networks is because it can increase compatibility with older devices, smart TVs, and printers, and also because 2.4 gigahertz networks tend to be better at certain things, and 5 gigahertz networks tend to be better at different things. Specifically, the 2.4 gigahertz network tends to have longer range. That's very good for phones or for devices that you move around a lot in the RV with, because you want those to be able to work outside on the patio, through the walls and whatnot. The 5 gigahertz has a benefit though, in that it's faster. It can carry more bandwidth over its wireless connection. That tends to be really good for things like desktop computers, possibly a smart TV that's not going to move around a lot. And by balancing what devices are connected to the 2 gigahertz versus the 5 gigahertz, you can optimize your network to support more devices overall. If that's over your head and you're like, oh, what am I doing? Don't worry. We're gonna walk through the specific settings that we recommend for all users for setting up their wireless. So let's hop on over to the computer and we'll run through everything to get your Pepwave from getting out of the box to being set up and ready to rock.
All right, so let's get started. I've got my screen share here. And before we start, we want to make sure that we have all of the antennas connected. A lot of folks think, oh, I've got 2 cellular antennas, or maybe 4 in the case of one of our transit series. I just can hook up 1 while I'm doing testing. I don't need all these antennas. That is absolutely not true. All antennas must be hooked up. The only exception is this GPS antenna, and the location will be slightly different depending on the model of your unit, but that one can be left off. Everything else needs to remain connected, otherwise you will experience a lot of interference and problems with your Wi-Fi setup. Now that you've gotten yourself into the Pepwave dashboard, it's time to configure this optimally. So let's go ahead and do that now. This is a default modem, so this is basically right out of the box, fresh. If you've made any changes to your device, you can reset it back to factory by following our factory reset instructions, which are available at support.mobilemusthave.com. Just go ahead and search reset. You'll find the reset article. Or you can simply modify any settings you changed back to what we're going to show you here today, whatever's easier for you. So to start, we're going to go to the AP tab, all things related to access points or wireless are going to be on that AP tab. and we're going to create a new wireless network here. We're not going to mess with this one that's already existing because we're connected to that network. We will delete it later, but we want to create a new one now so that we don't get disconnected from the modem. I'm going to assume we're setting this up for the Smith family, and we're going to call the first wireless network we create the Smith family 2 gigahertz network. And as we said before, 2 gigahertz will have longer range and more compatibility, but it will be a little bit slower. But it's usually the most reliable kind of what I do everything with network. However, the 5 gigahertz, again, will be faster and can work better in certain really, really dense campgrounds where there's tons of Wi-Fi on the 2 gigahertz range. So we got our name of our wireless, this SSID up here. That's going to give us kind of what pops up over here when we look for Wi-Fi. And we're going to leave all of these other settings the same except for security. We want to absolutely make sure we set a password to our Wi-Fi. We're going to select WPA2 personal. The reason why we're selecting that is because WPA3 can have some compatibility issues with older technology and older phones and printers. And if you select WPA, WPA2 down here, most iPhones will give you a security warning saying that your Wi-Fi is insecure. So WPA2 is a really good blend right in the middle. We're then going to create a shared key. This is your password to your Wi-Fi. So what do we want our password to be? I'm going to create a simple one here with a capital letter, some numbers, and a symbol. You can set this to pretty much anything you want. I believe the only requirement is it has to be 8 digits long. We like to say just set it to be something that people can't guess, but is also something you won't forget. This will be case sensitive. And that's it. That's all you need to change on this screen. We're going to go ahead and hit save. And then we're going to repeat the process for the 5 gigahertz network. And we're going to select the same security settings, and we're going to create the password to match. You don't have to have them match, but I find it's easier to just have one wireless password for both of my networks. It's easier to remember that way. The next step is that we're going to go up to the settings screen here, and that's going to allow us to assign the radios to each of our networks. So 2.4 gigahertz, we're going to uncheck the 5 gigahertz, and 5 gigahertz, we're going to uncheck the 2.4 gigahertz. We can leave pretty much everything else on this screen as default. There's no need to really change anything else here. And this preferred frequency that you see here won't matter because you don't care about preferred frequency since you'll simply just connect to the network frequency you want based on the name of the network. We'll go ahead and hit save here. And then you'll see up top here it says that you need to click the apply changes button. We're actually not going to do that yet. We're going to go back to the wireless SSID tab. And then we're going to delete the Pepwave 380 default network. It's going to ask if we're sure. We're going to say yes. And now we're going to hit the apply changes button. Now the modem is deleting the network we are connected to and creating our two new networks. The net result of this screen will no longer work. It will probably error out and say cannot connect. What we need to do is wait. Remember, be patient, it's going to get there, it'll reprogram about 30 to 60 seconds, and then we're going to click on the Wi-Fi icon up here, and our new Smith Wi-Fi network, or whatever you change the name to, will appear in this list. Again, this modem is in our corporate office, so you can't see it in the list, but it will appear. Once you click on that network, it's going to pop up that password request, and this is going to be that password you set in the wireless configuration tab for your network. In our case, it was the welcome 2020 dollar sign. And then hit join. I'm not going to because that's not the password to the network for me, but it would be for you. Once you join, you're essentially done. You're online. Now you've got your 2 gigahertz and your 5 gigahertz wireless. They're configured and ready to go. Typically, we recommend folks connect their smart TVs and things that are in close proximity to the Pepwave and that don't move around a lot to the 5 gigahertz. Laptop computers, that you may want faster speeds for voice over IP, et cetera, would be also good for 5 gigahertz. And then legacy devices, older devices, printers, Amazon Echoes, stuff like that, you would go on the 2 gigahertz typically, because that longer range helps out those devices that may have smaller antennas in them.
All right, so your wireless should be set up optimally. Thanks so much for watching this video, and we'll see you on the road.